बार ओके तो वी वर अंटिल नाउ अब कोई एक्सेस नहीं कर सकते। 50 मिनट बाद आएगा तो क्या कैसे शुरू होगा? इस लिख दो ग्रुप पे जो और क्योंकि इसके बाद पढ़ाएंगे या एडमिट करते रहेंगे बैठ के। ठीक है
एक्सक्यूज मी सर, सर वी आर नॉट एबल टू हियर एनीथिंग। सर वी आर नॉट एबल टू हियर एनीथिंग।
ओके okay let us see whether it works because I am taking offline class so with that I don't know how do I manage because it is I don't know okay, anyhow let us see now are you able to hear
yes sir better
okay
yes sir
fine so I put these here okay so basically with that criteria that criteria we need some guideline as for example you know until now for organic compound for example like four anilines are not stable like that in inorganic chemistry also there are certain like guidelines which dictates whether a compound has to be stable or not so that is called 18 electron rule So, okay. By the way, I should tell that I will share this PDF also for your convenience because of this technical problem. If there is won't understand all of these things, you can read the PDF also. So, the 18 electron rule is actually characterizing and predicting the stability of the molecules. Then. Why the 18 electron rule is important? Why not it is 16 electron rule? Why not it is 14 electron rule? Why not it is 20, 22 electron rule? Why it is always 18? Be louder because I cannot come to you. most able. But why most able?
Sir, it achieved noble gas configuration.
Why?
Sir, it achieved noble gas configuration, that's why.
Yeah, 18 electron, if it is a element, then it will attain a noble gas configuration, that is fine. But in a compound where molecular orbitals are involved, they are... Somebody has switched on their own...
Rajat, please switch off your mic.
Everyone, please switch off your mic. Yes. Okay. Somebody was telling something. Yeah, noble gas configuration. Yeah. In case of molecular orbitals, when the molecular orbitals are involved, at that time, how do you explain it? The idea is same. Idea is basically the same. That in every case, if the octet is not filled or 18 of the valency electrons are not filled, if there is a vacancy in the last cell, then definitely some electron can be taken or some electron can be donated. And that will involve the reaction of that particular complex. Correct? So, yeah.
Octahedral
complex, then it will not enter into the antibonding level. Then it will be all remaining within the bonding, even not the non-bonding. That is written here, you see. That's why the CO have a additional electron which can be donated, and in the return of the donation, it can get the back donation from the metal to have a pi star bonding, right? That's why it is reactive, right? So, like, if there is a reactivity, there has to be a reason from the molecular orbital perspective, as I said, right? But in case of a complex, whether it is coordination, whether it is organometallic, in that case, for example, valency cells of a metal will be having 18 electrons, 2 in each of the 5 d orbitals, 2 in each of the 3 p orbitals, and 2 in the s. CO may be not the you take NO, then in that case it will enter. NO is take anything suitable, then it will enter in case of ligands. In case of coordination compound, it will not enter because of this. How can it enter? Because you have the vacancy of that much. If all the orbitals of the metal are involved, for example, all the 5 d orbitals are involved, that means these 5 d orbitals will be involved in case of octahedral geometry. Now, correctly you said one thing, that if now I involve a tetrahedral complex where all the d orbitals are not involved, then what happens? For example, dz square in a tetrahedral complex, or better to say square planar complex, will not be involved. Right, square planar complex means everything will be in the xyz, x and y plane. So dz square will be vacant. Then what happened? Question is this. What is the answer? Anybody from there? Answer is the same. You have to take care of the molecular orbitals. That means if your one of the orbital is not participating, you have to take out that electron from your number. That means, in that case, it will be following instead of 18 electron rule, 16 electron rule, correct? Simple. Do you understand now? Exactly as you said, this is the case that in the case of participation of all the 5 d orbitals, 3 p orbitals and 1 s orbital, that means altogether total orbital number is 5 plus 3 plus 1. How much? 9. So then you can expect 18 electron rule has to be followed. But if the complex is such of such geometry that the particular orbital is not participating at all, for example square planar geometry, then the number will come down to 16, because altogether there will be 4 d orbital, 3 plus 1. So 4 plus 3 plus 1 means 18, 16, right? So total will be 8 into 2 equals to 16. So then the total orbital, total electron count will come to 16. Exactly like that way it will go. I thought that I will tell it later, but as you already pointed out, it helps me a lot. Thank you. Okay. So basically with that introduction, now we have understood why 18 electron is very much important for the stability of a particular compound, may it be coordination, may it be your orthogonal compound. Now let us see. Okay, now let us see how good. Can all see, right? Fine. So now if for example the 18 electron has to be counted for a complex, then you should know how a particular metal is giving how many number of electron and how many number of electron is now coming from the ligand, because both the metal and the ligand can have electron, or it can also be in a, it is not a necessary criteria is that you have to have altogether 18 electrons, but it can also happen that all the ligands are donating all the 18 electrons, metal is not donating anything, or it can be the other way around also, correct? So that means you have to know how many electrons are coming from the metal and how many are coming from your ligand. So if that is the case, there are some ligands are actually given here, which are normally in a coordination compounds you deal with the ligands like water, ammonia, right? Then what are the common ligands you know? You know anything else? Water, ammonia, you know, then what else? Chloride, bromide, halides, all of these things you are the ligands, common ligands. But in case of organometallic chemistry, the same thing we will extrapolate into little different kind of ligands. For example, these, which are nothing but basically the unsaturated ligands, you can say, or you can also say that they are will be having metal carbon direct bonds, correct? So for example, if this one is now will be having, then basically you have to go to metal C bond of the R has to be created, and that because of that it will be a organometallic compound, correct? Fine. Now also you can have a few ligands like CO, CaCO, this can happen. That these are all also nowadays, as I said, taken care within this periphery of the organometallic chemistry. Fine. Now, basically, you have to also know there are particular denotation to say how a ligand is bound to a particular metal. Right? For example, there can be a situation that the metals are bound by, there is a ligand which is coming, and in between the two metals that ligand is remaining equidistant. That means it is bound with two metals. Or it can happen, one metal is basically coordinated by many sites of a particular ligand. Correct? So these are all the possibilities can happen. So because of that, there are particular symbols are given there are particular symbols are given for denoting how the ligand is bound. For example, hepto symbol. You see, here is hepto symbol. It's a numeric superscript, or basically with that some numbers you have to be there, which provides a topological description by indicating the connectivity between the ligand and the metal central atom. For example, if the five carbon atoms of a cyclopentadiene, CP is the nothing but cyclopentadienyl ligand, right? What does it mean? Can anyone draw quickly in your notebook and show me? How is the cyclopentadienyl ligand can be there? Enyl means there will be anion. Correct? So can you draw cyclopentadienyl? Cyclopentadiene. Draw in your notebook cyclopentadiene first, and they put an anion and show me how it will look. So, for example, cyclopentadiene is how much? How will it look? Cyclopentadiene, correct? Now I have to have an anion. Where the anion can happen? So there it will not be remaining like that. Correct? Because why not? How many electrons? Six. So six means it is aromatic or anti-aromatic? Aromatic, right? So it will attain an aromaticity. So because of what? Because of that, it will, instead of the charge being localized, it will be fine. This is cyclopentadienyl ligand. And now you see that previously there was, if the charge would be here, then the binding would have been very prominent from this side. Right? But now all the carbons of cyclopentadienyl are equivalent. Right? So how do you say that cyclopentadienyl will be bound by only one?
That is also correct.
That's what we will see. That's what the 18 electron rule is the guiding. For example, if the metal environment is like that after getting all the electron, it is going to 19 electron or 20 electron. What cyclopentadienyl will do?
Then cyclopentadienyl, normally the bonding of the cyclopentadienyl is shown by this way. This is means it is bound with all the five. If instead of if I stop it here, then it is bound with the C1. If it is extended, given a circle which is basically aromatic. And if it is extended at the computer, that means it is bound with all the five carbons to the metal. Now, that means, now let me tell you, if the five carbon is participated into the bonding, then there will be five electron donation from cyclopentadiene. Now, for example, if there is already 40 electron on the metal, from other ligands and the metal electrons. Saltwater it will then coming to 19. If it is so.
But 19 is not a stable number. Then what it will do?
It will deviate from its equivalent bonding scheme to rather for example, it may go.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you use any kind of digital board or
no,
something?
Yeah, no, we don't have. What can I do?
Okay, sir.
Okay, so. Yeah. Right. Now, this will be.
Maybe I just try to put it.
This can you see?
Yeah, I
hope you can see that. Yeah. So basically, you see, now it will be bound with four of the carbon leaving this electron. Then instead of five electron donation, it will be four electron donation. 4 + 14 = 18. By this way, by the number of overall electron to maintain the number 18, right? It means the electron will overflow from the bonding orbitals, right? So any of the ligand will be twisted in such a way that basically overall thing should come to 14. That is basically the underlying overall thing. But now, before we go into that details, we will show some examples like that. Before we go into that details, we have to first understand that how we will calculate that 18, number 18, right? And that is the exercise for today. So now you see, there will be the eta. As I said, there is a eta, which, for example, number of the particular number of, it is called actually like a, with the numericals provide a topological description by indicating the connectivity between the ligand and the central atom. That means how many atoms of a particular ligand is bound to the metal. Fine. Then there will be also symbol like mu. Mu indicates bridging, right? Normally we have mu2, mu3, all of these bridging things. What does it mean? This means how many metals together are bound with that particular ligand. So mu2CO means, mu2CO means the CO ligand is now bound with two metals. Mu3CO means now the CO ligand will be bound with three ligands. CO ligand will be bound with three metals. And here, CO ligand is bound with the two metals. So, the number of metals with which a particular ligand is bound is given by the symbol mu. Okay, now let us start calculating. Okay, before that I would go how to know the number, correct? For example, these are different type of ligands might occur in your aromatic chemistry. And see how many electrons they are actually donated to the metal for bonding. If it is carbonyl, metal carbonyl, normally metal carbonyl donates 2 electrons. Then phosphine, then 2 electrons, amines, 2 electrons. So all the neutral ligands, normally they are donating 2 electrons, except for example, nitrosyl. Nitrosyl case, if it is linear, then nitrosyl will donate 3 electron. If it is bent, then nitrosyl will donate 1 electron. You have to remember these numbers, how many electrons will be coming from a particular ligand. Now for the anionic ligands, notice, what is the first anionic ligand here? Amide. Then hydrogen. Hydrogen is not hydrogen, it is hydride. Because hydrogen ligand is not possible. Hydride. Then next is, for example, alkoxide, OR minus. Then it can be, for example, alkyne,
R minus.
In all the cases, the charge will be the number. The charge will be the number, I repeat. For example, if there is a minus one charge, it will be giving you one electron. Correct? Okay. Then you see. Correct. And next type of ligands are basically eta type of ligands. You see, in the case of eta type of ligands, eta number will give you the number of electrons being donated by a particular ligand. If it is eta 3, then usually it will be giving 3 electrons, you see. 3 electrons. Eta 5 means 5 electrons. Eta 6 means 6 electrons. Like that. Carbine will be giving you 3 electrons because it is a metal carbon triple bond. Carbene will be giving you 2 electrons because there will be metal carbon double bond. Thiolate, how many electrons? Why so? Cyclohepta triene. And by this way, as I mentioned here, you can draw it. So everyone draw the structure of the cyclohepta-trienyl ligand. How this ligand will be, draw it. Okay, so next question is that thiolate. Why thiolate is giving one electron? Because it is negative. Right, as I said, if it is charged, then the charge will be the number. Unless that is there is also kind of a mu 2 type. Mu 2 means you have to consider charge in one side and for example, I give you an example, what are your halides? Correct. Now you see, mu 2
chloride ligand basically, right? If it is normal chloride, how many electrons it will give? 1. But now it is mu 2 chloride, means how many electrons it will give? 3. Because normally it will give 1 for one particular metal, but now it is also bridging with another one metal. To that it will give another 2 electrons. So altogether 3 electrons. So therefore mu 2 chloride will now be 3 electron donor, mu 2, all these things. If it is mu 2, then it has to give now 3 electrons. Now, for example, let me see you here. Yeah, but remember one thing, if it is mu 2 CO or mu 3 CO, all will give only 2 electrons. Why? Because CO have only 2 electrons. Chloride, it is having the lone pairs, that's why it can donate. But CO, all the others are actually bonding type electrons. Only the non-bonding electrons can participate into your bond, or can be donated to the metal. Right? But CO don't have more than 2 electrons in their non-bonding level. So there is no chance. That's why whenever CO is involved in the metal ligand bridging, those bonding will not be like a two center, two electron, not in that way, or three center, three electron will not be happening. Then it will be three center, two electron bonding, four center, two electron bonding. So multiple center, two electron bonding is basically are called the banana bonds, correct? So this type of banana bonds are therefore very much common. That is the eta. Eta number is called the heptacity number. Right? It was written here. You was wanted to ask something? कोई कुछ और पूछना चाहते हैं? ठीक, दिखाता हूँ. That will come again. We will revisit it here. Okay. So no issues. I just wanted to give you a feeling that how. Okay. Now. You see, alkoxide. Here also, one electron from the negative charge, another two is from the because of the cohesion to the other side, right? Mu, if it is like a just given the mu means it is mu two. Remember it. If it is any number is not given, only mu written means it is mu two. Because if it is like if it is only one. Bound with only one metal, then there will be no mu. Mu means it has to be mu two, right? If it is mu three or more, then you have to specify it. Correct? So that's why you see these are all the different terminologies will be used, and you have to understand that. So mu means in that case it is mu two, not the mu one. Mu one means it's bound to only one metal, then there is no need of mu, right? Once it is mu given, as you can see, in that case, it must be mu 2, right? And mu 2 means, as I said, if it is negatively charged, then 3 electron donor. Okay, so these are basically there are two types of counting methods are there. One is called neutral count and one is called charge count. If you are taking the charge count, then these are the electron numbers. Three individuals. Why so? As you can see, here, for example, cyclopentadienyl have now five sides to for electron donation, right? So 5 plus there is a charge. So therefore there is 6 is taken. By this way, but you will soon realize that charged electron count is little bit complicated than the neutral count. That's what neutral count is easy to follow. Of course you can follow the charge count, but in that case you have to be very cautious because charge count, as I said, is little bit tricky. Okay. I will show both of that now. Okay, so this is the thing. Now I go back to the particular example. Fine. Now, for example, I would like to ask you, what are the total electron number on the metal because of the coordination, right? Now you see, ruthenium by neutral count is how many electron donor? Remember, you just have to remember the whole periodic table, or basically at least the transition elements, right? Can anyone say all the transition elements without seeing anything? Start from group number 3, scandium, yttrium, then lanthanum. Correct? All of these things are there. Then basically, next is basically titanium, then zirconium, then hafnium. Magnesium. No. I am talking always whenever you are going to the group, you have to go by vertical. Horizontally, you can also go, that is not an issue. It will be a scandium, titanium, vanadium, then chromium, then manganese, then iron, then cobalt. But in this case, the particular problem is that you are not getting the group number. That's what you have to remember the group number vertically. This is the trick, right? So go with it. Scandium, then yttrium, all of this thing is there. Then titanium, zirconium, hafnium, vanadium, niobium, tantalum. Then chromium, molybdenum, tungsten, right? Then manganese, technetium, rhenium, correct? Then your iron, ruthenium, osmium, right? Then what is next? Upper iron, cobalt, rhodium, iridium, nickel, palladium, platinum, copper, silver, gold, zinc, cadmium, mercury. This is the way you have to remember it. Because then what will happen? You will be, once there is a metal, you know it is coming from this group. And immediately this number at the top, this number you can get immediately from the group number itself. You don't have to think. I see iron means I will put 8. Without thinking how, what is its oxygen state, all of this. Because why the actually the charge count is difficult? Because of the fact that you must be sure. In a coordination compound, it's rather easy to know what is the oxidation state of a metal. But in case of organometallics, because of the so many like bonding schemes, it is sometimes very difficult to know what is the exact oxidation state of a metal. And that actually the complicates the counting. But there is also, that's why the neutral counting is there. Neutral counting means you just have to remember that group number of a particular metal. Iron means without thinking anything, I will put 8 first. Fine. So 8 is there. Then I put hepta-3-allyl. Right? Hepta-3-allyl. Hepta-3 means, again, you don't have to think. Number 3. Because hepta-3. Correct? So 3 electron is coming. Then PPH3. H should be like a not a subscript. PPH3. So PPH3 means each of the PPH3 is a neutral electron. Neutral means 2 electrons. So 2 into 2, 4. 4 is given. CO again, 2 electron given. And now, because until now you did not take care of the charge of the complex, now you have to take care of the overall charge of the complex. Overall charge of the, without thinking what is the metal charge, what is the ligand charge, all of this thing you don't think. Now directly go to the overall charge, which is +1. Put +1. +1 means it is electron count. So 1 electron will be less. So -1, that means. Right? So now you see it is coming 16. And why it becomes 16? Because it is 4 coordinated. 4 coordinated means there will be participation of only 4 d orbitals, not the 5 d orbitals. That is what it is expected and that is what it is finding. Understandable? Now, the next one. Iron means without thinking 8. Now, eta 5. Again, I don't think. 5 is the electron number into 2. So, that means altogether it is 10 plus 8, 18. Without any fallacy, this number. And why it should be 18? Because it is bound by all the 3 dimensions. That means all the all of your XYZ orbitals of the or oriented orbitals of the D has to participate. That means all the D 5D orbitals have participated into the bonding, and total number must be 18. The number is 18, so it is stable. That is the way to judge the stability of a particular complex. Or it is often a popular question in all the complex. Basically, you can go to in any of the exams. Now onwards, you will see one at least the question on this. At least one. Of minimum marks will be 4, maximum can be until 10.
Okay, so that means you have to this thing, other thing you all forget, no problem, but you have to remember this thing very, very carefully. Now onwards, your competitive exam, your class exam, your assignment, everything. Okay, assignment, I cannot say that what will be there, but each of your exam must be having a question on this. Minimum marks will be 4, maximum marks until 10. So remember this thing very carefully. And there is nothing much to remember. Negative charge, see whether it is bridging or not. Not bridging, one electron. Bridging, mu 2 bridging, 2 electron. If it is, for example, now chloride is mu 3, but how many electrons will come? Quick question. 5. Because two of the other metals will be having 2 plus 2, and because of the negative charge, 1. 5 electrons. Right? By this way, you have to judge. If it is neutral ligand, then 2 electron. Look, but before putting this rule that 5 electron, you just see whether it is having 5 electron or not. Halides mostly have, but if it is CO, you know, then there are a particular number of electrons which is present because of its, try to draw its quick MO diagram and see how many non-bonding electrons are there. For CO, the number of non-bonding electrons are always 2, right? And that, by this way, you have to judge. But once you practice quite enough and follow this that two charts, I think it is quite easy, correct? And this is actually very easy scoring questions, okay? Fine. So, yeah, another thing is that often it is the case that student will come, sir, I put here 8, but here there was already I have taken care of the charge of the ligand, so why is, no. Focus on only one counting method. Do not mix, okay, neutral and this thing together and then try to do something that will never match. And the charge cone method, or sometimes also called the oxidation state method, because it is depending on the oxidation state because of the charge, it will be depending. So because of that, it is like that. Okay. Okay. So I will quickly finish. Next class will be here only, right? Yes, sir is not here. Is sir here? Okay, fine. We'll continue until sir come. Okay. So again, as I said, the electrons specifically it is written how many electrons will be donated, all of these things. Then a few more examples are given. These are easy to follow. Okay, follow it from your end. Ah, sir. After class, sir. Sir. Okay. Now, only one last example I would describe. Basically, if you have, for example, Mu2CO9. Now, there are two metals. How will you calculate? Nothing you have to see on. Just put 2 for 2 of this one. But in this case, what only you have to see, is there a metal-metal bond? If there is a metal-metal bond, you have to take 1 electron extra. Or depending on how is the metal bond. If it is a triple bond, 3 electron extra. If it is a double bond, 2 electron extra. Right? By this way, if you follow, it will be again the coming, per metal to 1 electron. That means bond needs always to, a bond always need 2 electron. That means 2 electron you can put together and then you divide it by the number of metal ions here. Right? Then it will be, it will come 36 divided by 2 because of the 2 metal will be coming to 18 electron. Okay.
Fine. In this above example also, you can see, you can calculate that also it should come that 36 electron. Fine. Are we concept class are we? Which classes? Sir? Yeah, madam?
Lal Bahadur, sir.
Oh, Lal Bahadur, sir. Okay. Sir is not here, right? Let me check.
सर लिंक आ गया है क्लास का
जो ही है हाँ ठीक है मैं तो खत्म कर देंगे अभी ठीक है अच्छा these are different complexes we will see one by one all of these things or you can also look at your from your end okay so how to determine the number of metal bond that will be we will be talking in the next class then okay From the 18 electron rule only, we have to determine, okay? Fine. So this is, one only caution that these are the drawbacks of this 18 electron rule. 18 electron rule is a rule, not a law. A rule and law difference is there. A law means it's a universal. But rule means might be there are some exceptions. And you should be aware of those exceptions, correct? And this is basically a formalism, that's why it is told. In many cases, if the coordination is lesser than 4, okay, lesser than 4, then it is very dangerous to apply the 18 electron rule. There might be, it is not actually following it, okay, because even not the 16 electron, it might follow, because sometimes it may be even 14 electron is stable. So that will only be happening if your number of coordination is very, very low. Like for example, 2 coordinated, 3 coordinated, then you have to be very cautious before putting this rule. Good. Okay, there are some exceptions. You can read the exceptions. Okay, fine. So with that, we will, today's basically lesson was the 18 electron rule. Okay, so you can read it. I will send you the this PDF. Fine. Then this is the end of today's class. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.